So ready and go. So in this one, how many values of n where n is an integer are there so that this expression here is also an integer? Well, if that's to be an integer, then you don't want any negative values, that's for sure. But being powers of 4, you could have square roots, you could have a denominator of 2. In other words, that has to end up equaling 4 to the n upon 2, where n would also be an integer, but n would have to be greater than or equal to 0. Now, you could do it numerically. Although, as soon as you write that, it's obvious there's a little equation to make up. This should equal that. But you could do it numerically and say this. Well, if n was 0, you'd have negative 1 over 1, which is negative 1, which is no use, because that means the whole expression is going to be a quarter, so n isn't equal to 0. In which case, either n is going to be greater than 0, or n is going to be less than 0. Now, if n is greater than 0, this expression has got a limit. This expression, because the numerator is smaller, has to be less than 1, which means if n is a positive integer, then the only two values you could get for this that would work would be 0 and a half. Similarly, if n is a negative number here, then this value will come to more than 1, simply because a negative number going back 1 gives a bigger portion of that negative number than the denominator. And of course, greater than 1, remembering kind of halves in it, greater than 1 would be 3 upon 2, 2, 5 upon 2, 3, and so on. That seems to go on forever. But you notice the answer's only got up to a maximum of 5. Now you could figure out which ones work. It's quite lengthy actually doing it this way now I've started. Well, numbers greater than 0. So first of all, n is 1. There you go, top 0. Another thing is, this bottom part's going to have to give a multiple of 2 or just 1. 1's fair enough. So the next number after 1 would be, 2's no use because that gives a 3, would be 3. And 3 gives 2 over 4, so there you are. So there's 2 values so far. Now the negative numbers. Well, negative numbers, the first one would be negative 1, which is no use because that gives a 0 in the denominator. Negative 2, that's okay because again I'm looking for 2's, but negative 2 gives a negative 1. That gives negative 3 over negative 1, so there you go, that's negative 2. Negative 3. Negative 3 gives a negative 4 over a negative 2, which is a 2. So that one's been jumped. But one thing you notice now is these seem to be going this way, and there's a limit there because it's got to be greater than 1. So even without working this one out, I can see there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, if this works, if you can find one for this. Well, the next one to try after negative 3 would be negative 5. Negative 5 gives a negative 6 over a negative 4. Which is 3 upon 2, so there you are, there's 5 of them. So the answer's E. But you probably wouldn't have done that if you'd written this down first of all, because there's an obvious equation. N minus 1 over N plus 1 has to be some number upon 2, where this has to be greater than or equal to 0. Well, take that 2 across and you've got this. 2N minus 2 over N plus 1 has to equal N, where n is an integer greater than or equal to 0. In other words, that's got to divide exactly into the top. So which values of n divide exactly in? Well, the wee bit of the pest here is I've got n's in the top and the bottom. But that's not a problem because you can just get rid of the one from the top by dividing it out. You can either divide it out or you could just say, well, manufacture a multiple of this in the top. Whoops. And then see what we've got. So with 2n, that would be a 2n plus 2. To recreate this, I'll have to take away 4. Now I've got that divides into that twice, minus, and then the 4 still gets divided by this part. This has got to be an integer greater than 0. In other words, n plus 1 has got to divide exactly into 4. Now there's not many possibilities. Either it's equal to 1, or it's equal to 2. Oops. Or it's equal to 4. Now that looks like 6 possibilities, But the whole expression n's got to be greater than or equal to 0. And whatever this is going to be subtracted from 2. It's okay subtracting a 1 from 2, it's okay subtracting a 2 from 2. It's not okay subtracting a positive 4, so I can't have that one. So even without working these out, because obviously they're just little linear equations with no divisions, there are 5 answers. In which case the answer is E.